Greetings, I'm Kanchan from Appulmec Technologies and you are welcome to Top Brass. Today we have Sitesh Srivastava from Johannesburg, South Africa. He has a vast experience in teaching IT professional and marketing professional, and he has a deep interest in corporate coaching. So welcome to Top Brass, Sitesh.
Thank you, Kanchan. How have you been?
Yeah, I'm very well. I'm very fine. Busy in all work which we have to do from home. And what about at your neighborhood, how people are reacting to this lockdown? Because now people can't go out in the parks and they have to follow social distancing. So how children and young people are reacting to this situation?
Mixed reactions, I would say. But most of the reactions that I am seeing is like surprise, once in a lifetime kind of a reactions, Kanchan. And it is very, very hard for everyone to understand what has just happened or what is still happening and how long will it happen. From the children to the kids to the teenagers to the adults to the old age people, everyone, corporates, everyone is very, very surprised. In fact, they're scared. And you know what? Human race is a strong race. They have overcome so many of those challenges before in centuries, in the recorded history and unrecorded history. So I'm sure that it will come out again.
This is quite a crazy time because life has suddenly changed. We are interacting through technology only. Now, what generally people say that change is the only constant in life. But then,
that's right.
Are we prepared to really face this change? We have any support system to manage this change in our lives? Because I see there's a lot of toll on the young children, especially school-going children, and of course on college-going students also. But I feel that there should be taught, there should be a subject of change management from early, from the school. Children should be taught about how to tackle the change in their lives, so that when change happens, they pass seamlessly and with confidence. What do you think about this?
So Kanchan, change happens anyway, whether we like it or not like it, change happens. The time that ticks in our house, the clocks, the walls, it keeps changing. The only thing is that we try to bring in a sense of calm and continuity in our dealings with people, in our dealings with children especially. But change is anyway happening. The only thing now is that it has become very clear that it cannot remain in the background of our mindset and our consciousness. It has to be told and trained, and children need to be told that every second life is changing, situation is changing, the stage is changing. And therefore, students, children at home, youngsters at home or in the colleges or in the corporate life, they need to be told to live in uncertainty that a time change brings.
Correct.
The moment we talk about change, people become uncertain.
Right.
They don't want to change. They don't want to change the processes. They don't want to change the functionalities. But then, whether they like it or not like it, you know, somebody had told me years back, the biggest change in the last 50, 60 years that has happened is the change nobody could have stopped, is the technological change. So I feel that it is better to embrace the change, agree to the change, and talk about it and tell people and ourselves that the next moment the life will change, mm-hmm. and we should prepare for it.
Yeah, so one last point which I want to discuss with you, that is it now very essential or very important to have a subject of a change management in the curriculum of students?
Yes, I think so. And it why I say I believe that what you say is that we live in a very, very interconnected world where a tutor or an educator is not the only sole education or knowledge provider. Everybody can go to a Google or a Bing search or any search and find out a lot of other information probably that educator doesn't know. And the millennials or the generation alpha or generation Z millennials, they basically define their life around technology. And therefore, they are always questioning. They are questioning their parents. They are questioning their educators. Whatever we say, whatever you say, they will suddenly, but you know what, I saw this. So they know that there is something that they can find out better and faster than us. So they are the natural inheritors of this change management curriculum. So going forward, for everyone, for the educators like us, for the students, everyone needs to have the skill sets which I put them into these categories: resiliency, flexibility and adaptability, emotional intelligence, continuous learning, creativity and critical thinking, and at the most important, entrepreneurial skills. And I think this should be the part of the curriculum, but I will leave it to the top educators of different countries in which grade to start this. Whether it should be in the primary education, it should be in the secondary, or it should be somewhere later in life.
Yes, true. And you have put it very beautifully. We will be discussing about this change management in education and in the lives of young people in further shows. For today, I would like to thank you. We have learned so much about change management. I'll see you soon on Talk Plus program.
Thank you. I wish all the best.